It is Heat Radio. I'm Sarah Powell. I am delighted to have on the show Don Cheadle. Hello, sir.
Hello, Sarah.
What a voice, Don. Already I can tell we're going to have a great time. The film is miles ahead. The story of Miles Davis. Now, I've got to confess, Don, I mean, I knew he was legendary. Mm-hmm. I knew he played the trumpet.
Good. Yeah. That's two. Perfect.
That's about it.
That's enough.
Yes. Yeah. But I wondered what your sort of personal experience of him was. When did you first hear his music? I mean, did you grow up with it? How did you come to it? You did?
Yeah, very young. It was music that my parents listened to. It was, you know, in a way, I guess, the soundtrack of my childhood in some ways. And I came up playing, you know, jazz and in bands and all through high school, and was in the jazz choir and sang. And so it's something that, you know, that music has been near and dear to my heart for many years.
Yeah. And how, when you started researching the film and sort of getting stuck into the actual story of it, your opinion must have changed of him, did it?
No, I think it just strengthened. Okay. I mean, I had read his autobiography, the Quincy Troupe book that Miles did in college. Because he was just someone that, you know, I was already taken with very early.
And is it true you played sax when you were kind of growing up? And how was it learning the trumpet for this?
Tricky. Yeah. It's a difficult instrument and very challenging. And if you put it down for 3 days, you feel like you never played it in your life.
And I love the idea that you took it everywhere with you. Like you'd go around to somebody's house for dinner and just nip out and have a little go on it.
I didn't do it. Dinner, but I did. I would, you know, whenever I was on the set, I would go in this trailer and I'd play. And, you know, whenever I was traveling to do whatever work, I'd play in the hotel room, go in the bathroom where the acoustics were good and play. So yeah, I take it everywhere still.
Yeah. Oh, do you? So you've kept
it
up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I love being in a hotel room next to you. Go. That guy is playing trumpet in the bathroom.
And calling down to the desk and saying, "Could you tell him to shut the F up?"
Did you have that?
I have had that, yeah.
Oh my gosh, really?
Yeah.
Wow. I bet if they found out it was you, I'd go, "Oh no, it's Don Cheadle and he's doing a film."
Oh, it's Don Cheadle. Then tell him to give me some money and then shut the F up.
And let's talk about the voice, because that is so important to playing him. And I mean, it's scratchy and it's kind of, I don't know why I'm even bothering to do it in front of you. Thanks.
Yeah.
But I mean, how did you perfect that? Did you watch stuff? Did you listen to stuff? Or was it kind of there already?
No, you know, I watch stuff. I listen to stuff. And you work on it, you know. It's really like anything. I guess in some ways a vocal mask, and but my way into that stuff is always trying to figure out the way into it that is story, not just something that's an applique and kind of stuck on. I want to know what's behind that and why. And in Miles' case, it's a great, you know, story. He had throat surgery and on nodes or polyps, and he was told, you know, to take it easy and not strain his voice and not raise his voice. And he got into an argument with somebody about money, I think, and blew his voice out. And that's why Miles talks that way.
I had no idea. Mm-hmm. What an amazing thing. So you had that in your mind when you were kind of doing that scratchy thing. And did it hurt?
No.
Okay, it didn't.
No.
Because I'm almost watching it and I want you to drink tea or something. Do you know what I mean?
Right,
I'm like, oh, gosh.
Yeah.
And tell me about Ewan McGregor. Did you know each other already? How did he kind of come to be in it?
Ewan was fantastic. He, you know, I sent him the script. He read it. He loved it. Loved the part. Wanted to be a part of my first production and was just totally consummate professional and totally supportive and a lovely guy. I'm going to see him in about an hour and have lunch with him. He's great.
Did you take any little sort of keepsake from the set? Because, you know, any of the little records or things like that?
No, it's amazing. We shot in a converted, we actually found, because Miles lived in a converted church on the Upper West Side of Manhattan. And we filmed this in Cincinnati, but we found a family who was actually in the process of converting a church. And we were able to sort of piggyback on that process and move our set in there. And they've kept a lot of things from the set. They kept the spiral staircase that we built. They kept the way that we used their windows in the bedroom to look down over the main house. It's amazing because none of that stuff was to code, actually. So I hope they're okay.
I bet they were thrilled. Yeah. But yeah, you can come in and do the house. Well, you can do it, and then we'll just move in.
Yeah, and then hope that all those bolts that we did super quick to just get through a shooting would work.
Yeah, just be careful, everyone, in that house. Go steady on those steps.
Don't go down the steps too fast.